Shorten English Junior, November 1987. Start. Mr. Speaker, Sir, for 4 days we have had a very interesting discussion on the budget. I am really thankful to the honorable members for the very kind words they have said about the way in which the budget has been presented. The House has taken very kindly to the proposals which have been presented to it. I take pride in having had the cooperation of many sections of this House with reference to the budget proposals. I will now tell the House in what ways we have shown improvement over previous years. The House has also a right to know what we propose to do next year. I shall try to meet some of the points raised in the course of the discussion. The other points may be dealt with in the course of the discussion on the demands for grants. I shall only meet the broad criticisms without wasting much of the time of the House. Two kinds of political opinion are represented in this House. They are entitled to look at the budget from their own point of view. All of them take a subjective view of the budget. They have not taken an overall picture of the state as a whole. So, if the budget has not satisfied some sections of the people, it cannot be helped. I am sure the same type of criticism can be made in respect of the budget of any finance minister of any country, although he is the most popular finance minister. Many things can be said against his budget proposals because he cannot satisfy all individuals. In view of this, I want the honorable members to look at the overall picture of the state as it exists and see whether we have not tried to meet the situation to the best of our ability. I request the honorable members to look at the matter from that angle. If they do so, they will pardon me if I do not meet some of the criticisms. The most important feature of the budget is the food position in the state. Several speakers have referred to it. I am sure that in the next few days, when we discuss the various items of the budget proposals, reference will be made to the food situation again and again. That is the biggest of all the problems that are facing the government at present. Letter dated 5th December 1980 from Bima and Company, Calcutta to Messrs. Kesavan and Company, Madras. Dear Sirs, we have great pleasure in enclosing a copy of our office calendar and diary. We trust that it may prove of some use to you. It is not necessary for us to point out the great importance of advertising in the present day, but we think you will agree that if advertising is to be effective, it must be of good quality. We have recognized this, so we have made special provision for this. In the circumstances, we shall be pleased to receive your esteemed orders. We have recently established the most modern machinery. If you require any kind of printing, we shall be happy to quote our terms. We shall be pleased to send specimens so that you may be able to select any one of them. We shall be much thankful for your reply at an early date. Yours faithfully.